Marty Brown was born in the small town of Maceo in northeast Davis County near Owensboro, Kentucky on July 25, 1965. His parents, Vincent and Barbara Brown, introduced Marty to traditional country music and filled their home with early Elvis Presley rockabilly tunes. Marty grew up idolizing his favorite country stars, Johnny Cash, Hank Williams, George Jones, Merle Haggard, and listened faithfully to the pop rock duo of the Everly Brothers. Marty learned how to play his father's guitar at the age of 9. He started composing his own lyrics in his early teens, and by the time he graduated high school, Marty had stockpiled a considerable number of original songs. Marty made numerous trips to Nashville, knocking on doors, sleeping in alleyways, seeking out agents, and searching for venues to allow him to play his own country compositions. In 1991, the CBS News magazine show 48 Hours recorded a feature on struggling country music artists and highlighted Marty. The exposure led to Marty's first record deal with MCA. In 1991, Marty released his debut album, High and Dry. The album drew much praise for its raw energy and classical country depth.
I'm high and dry since you said goodbye.
The title track, High and Dry, and Every Now and Then, showcased his authentic voice. Marty's first tour to promote his first album on MCA was the Walmart tour throughout the Southeast. He was the only country music artist Sam Walton ever endorsed.
Sam Walton got contact with me and MCA Records and all the powers that be, and next thing you know, I was Sam Walton's favorite country music artist back in 1991. And so that's how it all started. I toured 40 Walmarts in 30 days. And I started that out, and I sold so many copies of that High and Dry album, and they started calling me Walmarty. All the big wigs at Walmart. Thank you, Sam Walton.
Marty routinely opened for Garth Brooks, George Jones, Alan Jackson, Patti Loveless, and Dwight Yoakam, to name a few. Marty was proud to be on the same record label as Loretta Lynn and Bill Monroe. Marty enjoyed a successful songwriting career as well. He and fellow Kentucky Music Hall of Fame inductee Richard Young of the Kentucky Headhunters co-wrote the heartfelt and groovy number one hit song, I'm From the Country, which became one of Tracy Byrd's signature hits.
Yeah, we know how to work and we know how to play. We're from the country and we like it that way.
Marty wrote the classic When I Stop Loving You for Trace Adkins. He and fellow songwriter Tony George co-wrote It Ain't Me If It Ain't You for Brooks and Dunn from their Hillbilly Deluxe album, which sold over 3 million copies. Marty co-wrote with Tommy Smith There's No Song Like a Slow Song for international sensation Engelbert Humperdinck. After taking some time off from the country music business in the mid-2000s, Marty made an auspicious comeback performance while auditioning for America's Got Talent in 2013. His rendition of To Make You Feel My Love captured the nation's heart and has received over 25 million views worldwide.
There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do. Make you feel my love.
The Bob Dylan single that Adele took to number one in 2008 reintroduced Marty Brown to a new generation of American country traditionalists. His success on the popular TV show prompted a new record deal with the independent label Dreamline Entertainment. In 2019, Brown released his fifth studio album, American Highway, on the Plowboy Records label. Marty Brown has remained true to his country music roots throughout his career. The small-town Kentucky entertainer writes and sings traditional country music from his heart. His voice is soulful, and his down-home personality is friendly and relatable. The smile on his face reveals his joy as he shares his musical talents with his devoted fans. Marty Brown has lived his life, shared his love, and has overcome struggles. He has experienced the sadness and joy of a true country artist. He has been called the Rocky Balboa of country music because he just keeps coming back round after round. Marty Brown is and will always be a beloved Kentucky country music icon.